And the Bears are back.
Congratulations. I was so happy.
The Bears are back.
Watching Big Cat watch this game is very exciting for me because you're lighting up like a Christmas tree, like a beautiful Fraser fir.
Oh, so much pain and angst from this season. Finally, the 2018 Bears have entered the chat. That was Mitch Trubisky is playing with confidence. That Detroit game, I'm telling you, and I know everyone's like, oh, it's Detroit. Oh, it's the line. It's the Cowboys. Their defense stinks too. Mitch is, I'm not going to go so far as to, you know, look into the future, but what I'm going to say about here and now, when he's playing with confidence, different guy.
Even his interception was good because he pinned him at the one.
Yeah, and we got the ball right back and then scored. His confidence, his decision-making, Matt Nagy, it's a chicken and egg. Matt Nagy's play calling has been phenomenal in the last two games. The defense is flying around the field. Akeem Hicks is coming back next week. I'm starting to get feelings. I'm happy for once that I actually let myself fall for the Bears. Before this game, you guys heard me all week. I was talking about it. I was like, I love the Bears on Thursday night. I love the Bears on Thursday night. I think they're going to win, and I think that it's going to be, you know, the Packers next week is going to be the biggest game of the season, and they didn't let me down.
Sometimes it's good to let your guard down a little bit.
They didn't let me down.
Expose yourself emotionally. Once in a while, the universe will give you a little treat. So I was glad to see it. And I must admit, I was invested as well. I bet on the Bears. And the fact that the Cowboys lost astronomically increases the Redskins' chances of winning the NFC East.
Oh, really?
At 7-9 from, I think, 0.5% to 0.9%.
Wow.
So we're still in this.
Huge.
We are in the hunt officially.
I wonder what the Bears' percentage is because it was 3% going into this game.
Full disclosure, I just made those up for me.
So I'm going to say the Bears now have a 75% chance of making the playoffs.
That's right.
NFC East is now a combined 15 for 33.
Wow.
Well, you know why? It's because we beat each other up.
Yeah.
It's a tough division. All those interdivisional games, they leave you banged up the next week and you lose to some teams that you shouldn't.
Okay, now before we shit on the Cowboys because they deserve to be shit on a lot, let me just talk for like one more minute about how awesome that Bears win was because Mitch, I mean, come on.
The jerseys.
The jerseys, the helmets. 1997 Camry, not so funny now, guys. That's the grittiness that we needed. No, he looks confident. He looks healthy. And I don't know. I mean, I know people are going to make the joke. Well, now you have to, you know, now it's another year. Mitch, I'm okay with that. He's football young. Late bloomer.
That's true.
Late bloomer.
He is football young. I actually read an interesting stat today. It was sent to me by Professor Chuck Cuck. That seems like a very prestigious
name,
title. But Lamar Jackson is probably going to be the MVP, right?
Mm-hmm.
Joe Burrow is likely going to be the Heisman. This, I think, would be the first year that the Heisman winner would be older than the NFL MVP.
Whoa. And what does that have to do with what we were talking about?
Lamar's NFL young, too.
Got it.
Yeah, but Mitch is very NFL young. He only threw, what, like he played 13 games in college?
Yeah.
So he's basically, this is his rookie
year. Sun Bowl doesn't even count.
This is his rookie year right now.
Yeah, and he looks good. He feels confident. That first pick was a terrible pick. And Mitch of old, pre-Lions Mitch, would probably have that derail him into a phantom injury that Matt Nagy has to bench him and throw him under the bus. Maybe that was the change. Maybe it was Matt Nagy benching him with no injury that lit a spark. I actually wouldn't be surprised if Matt Nagy tries to take like credit for that. Like, hey, remember that hip injury that I lied to you about?
No.
It was a lie.
I think that what we can give Matt Nagy credit for is he gave Mitch Trubisky one extra series of rest, which has made all the difference.
Right. He's so football young in the season.
For recovering, he recovered from that injury because he had that one series of rest, and his hip looks great. Here's a little spin zone about it.
Six touchdown passes, one rush TD in the last two games. Woo!
His interceptions, you can do like a spin zone on those. Because I think he just throws a sticky ball. I think he throws a very catchable ball.
Oh, he just one sucks sometimes.
One of his touchdown passes just like stuck in his receiver's chest tonight. And it works
sucks.
The same way for the defense.
Yeah, but I'm happy for him. Because I don't think there's anyone on the internet who gets shit on more than Mitch Trubisky right now in terms of sports, right? Like he has gotten dragged. And I've done a lot of the dragging. My hand is up. I've said many times when he's bad, I'm telling you he's bad. But to see him happy to see his teammates hugging him. I feel good for him. What are you going to say, Hank? You got someone else? I actually think he might be this season. I think he's been shit on more than any other player.
Yeah, I'm going through the list. I would say like Cam Newton when he wears an outfit after a loss.
But it still isn't like what Mitch has gotten, because he's gotten it from Mitch is in that rare thing where it's not only fans of other teams shitting on him, but analysts shit on him too.
It's because of the whole graphic that you can pull up with Deshaun Watson.
Of course, yeah. It's always going to be that. But the Bears are back next week, Green Bay. So
congratulations.
The flip side, thank you. The flip side, the Cowboys are a dumpster fire, are a joke, have quit. Look like they didn't want to be out there. They score early in the game. They 13-play drive to start the game, and I was like, okay, we're fucked. And they basically – I actually jokingly tweeted that that was savvy by the Bears to make the Cowboys use all their good plays. Little did I know that was actually true. They used all their good plays in the 13-play drive to start the game, and they sucked for the rest of the game. And somehow, as bad as they are, they're still in first place.